What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. It's pretty clear that gospel artist Tasha Cobbs has an active prayer life. How do we know that? Well, because she tells us. Recently on her Instagram, she made a post about a public prayer for Beyonce, about Beyonce's home, about Beyonce's life, about Beyonce's upcoming tour. Here, I'll read it to you. In a post to her Instagram account, she said, "I'm praying for Beyonce today," a thread. "Father, I pray that she would feel your presence very near to her today. I pray that your presence would fill any void and bring her unspeakable joy. Let her home be a sanctuary for you to meet with her. I pray that she would find rest and safety in you. I pray that her home would be a place of peace. I pray that anything that would come to distract her peace would be canceled now in Jesus' name. I pray that you would ease her prayers and concerns, make every burden light, cover and protect her from all evil, all harm, and all sickness and disease. Cover her heart and her mind from any thoughts or ideals that are not good and perfect. Protect her from the weight that comes with greatness. Allow her to enjoy the wins and grow from the losses. Lastly, the prayers that she may be praying in secret. Hear her and allow your will to be done. In Jesus' name, amen." Now, when I read this prayer, I said, well, that's good that Tasha is praying for Beyonce. But then I thought about what she actually said. She's praying for Beyonce's peace, praying for Beyonce's family, praying for Beyonce's home. Pretty much praying for everything in Beyonce's life, praying for her cat, her dog, her goldfish. But the one thing she didn't pray for was Beyonce's repentance. Now, Beyonce just announced recently that she's going on a Renaissance tour worldwide to celebrate the Renaissance album. You know, the album where she wrote the song Church Girl and had the church girls backing it up. We covered that on this channel. And it seems interesting to me that Tasha Cobbs would come out after such a big announcement when Beyonce's name is buzzing like the beehive and try to tap into that fame, try to tap into that buzz, try to get a little bit for myself. And I have to wonder, are you praying for Beyonce or are you praising Beyonce? I opt for the latter because this is the same Tasha Cobbs who did a song with Nicki Minaj. Now you're praying for Beyonce. Well, there's some commonality between these artists. If you look at the images, one to the other, you see that there's something going on there that is unlike what we should be promoting in the gospel music industry. But I've told you on this channel, beware of these gospel artists. Beware of the gospel music industry because the people who run it are no different than the people who run the secular music industry. It's all evil. It's all industry. And I couldn't help but notice that in Tasha Cobbs' prayer for Beyonce, she acknowledged to a great God, an almighty God, an omnipotent, omnipresent, omniscient God. She acknowledged Beyonce's greatness. And in the last part of the prayer, she asked God publicly on Instagram, she asked God to hear Beyonce's prayer that she may be praying secretly. Well, it would have been nice if Tasha Cobbs had prayed her prayer secretly because y'all came for her in the comments. I mean, when I looked at it, there were over 6,300 comments and the Christian community came out in force. I got to give it to y'all. People of all races, of all denominations stood up for Christ and told her how they felt. She made a public statement and the Christian community gave her a public response. And I was okay with the prayer itself. I have no problem with Tasha Cobbs. I have no reason to think that her prayer wasn't heartfelt, although I do think it was a clout chase. The problem I have with the entirety of this scenario is that when the Christian community addressed what they thought was their own, a gospel artist, when they addressed her directly in the comments, she shut them down. She turned the comments off and gave them a piece of her mind. That's my problem with the entire scenario, is the clapback. Tasha said, So I gave y'all 24 hours of opinion in the comments. That's big for me because I enjoy blocking and deleting asinine, sophomoric, and simple-minded people. I said what I said and prayed what I prayed with intention and precision. So in order to cover your ignorance and to keep you from making all of us look like imbeciles, I'ma go ahead and turn the comments off. She called y'all asinine. She called you sophomoric. Can you imagine the ego of this person that in the face of Christian correction, trying to guide her back on the right path because she's praising a known demon. In the face of that, she would say that every Christian who disagrees with her is ignorant and deserving of her covering. Not God's covering, but she's so great and mighty that I'm gonna do you a favor and I'm going to cover you all, because if I don't, you're gonna make all Christendom look like imbeciles. So Tasha Cobbs is saying she too deep for y'all simple-minded Christians. She too heavy for your ignorance. And perhaps you need to get your weight up and get on her level. Nah, we ain't doing that. This is a classic clout chase. She feels like she's above everyone. All you little people who in her comments are beneath her. And the only way to clout chase once you get to her level is to look up. And who's up? The great, the mighty Beyonce. So I'm going to use my little power to pray to my God to bless Beyonce. No, you're saying, hey, Beyonce, notice me. I'm on your side. I'm on your team. Pay me some attention. I know you got that church girl song that you're going to be performing on tour. You need a church girl to perform with you. You need a church girl to back it up on stage. Hi, I'm here, Beyonce. Y'all, be careful who you put your trust in. And only put your faith in God. Not these gospel artists. Not these rappers. Not these secular artists. Not the music industry. Put your faith in God. And only God. That way, you won't be an imbecile. Like the video. Subscribe to the channel. And share the video so we can get more musicians involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget. Without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time. Peace.